Hey YouTube, how's it going? Even though my Patreon followers will just hear this as an MP3, but this is going to be on a YouTube video. Render it when I get home. But I want to talk a little bit about Shane DK, since right now he's the subject of some very hot scrutiny, and I figure I might as well hop in on the dog pile because it's important. And I know some other people do have the similar experiences from what I and Trilldill Tom has been suffering lately. Suffering in quotes. I don't know how much I'm suffering from this, but anyways. Shane DK has basically two different kind of perspectives from people who are aware of him on the internet. People either see him as a very rational person who makes good educational style videos on YouTube. And then there's people who have that same view on top of him being a completely unhinged, irrational, lying sack of shit. I fall in that latter camp, and it's only a matter of time from the people who, are in the former will end up falling into the latter. And that's why he seems to have stagnated around the same general kind of subscription, base that he has. Now I've kind of stagnated on my viewer, my subscriber count, but that's for different reasons. And we're not going to get into that for this video. So Shane does make some very good quality material from time to time. There's occasions where he dips into bullshit. And for the most part, I would say that his channel is generally good, though I have some problems with his voice. But then again, that's just a personal preference and you can't please everybody. But overall, I enjoyed his channel when I was a subscriber. It was not until... I had a disagreement with him regarding the NAP that I really got to see his final form. And that was basically an exchange that I had and where he was trying to defend, the non-aggression principle, from some of the criticisms that Matt Zolinsky has. Now I have some criticisms of Matt Zolinsky, and even some criticisms of Matt Zolinsky's version of his critique of the non-aggression principle. But either way, I thought that what Shane was saying was completely, like, unfounded in terms of his criticism. And I addressed them. I addressed them in the comment section and in videos. And I'll post a link to all the videos that I've done about Shane in the past in the description box of the YouTube version. I'm not going to have time to do this in the Patreon, so I'll update it after I make the YouTube video, I guess. and Shane immediately upon first sight of my criticisms of the non-aggression principle, immediately turned it into not in terms of like, well, Jim, you're wrong and here's why. It's that I'm lying. And there's an old adage I don't know exactly what it was, because I'm not at home. It's not like I could look this stuff up. And I felt the need to just say something now. that, you know, you never attribute to malice what can be explained through stupidity. And this does not calculate to Shane at all. Like, he does not do this. It may very well be that I'm being ignorant or stupid or wrong, unknowingly, about the non-aggression principle, but that doesn't matter. What matters is that I'm saying something that he deems to be incorrect. And the only reason why you can be incorrect, according to Shane Killian, is that you're lying. And it's not possible for you to have any kind of form of just ignorance or cognitive dissonance or just false narratives or a bad understanding of philosophy or any of that stuff. It doesn't matter. You're a liar. And anytime that you disagree with him on something that's very fundamental to his worldview, be it skepticism, be it atheism, be it libertarianism, be it ethics, whatever, he will immediately call you a liar. And not just call you a liar, but say so in all caps, fucking liar. And it's very apparent when he types in comment sections. It sounds like some of the interactions that I've had with members of like the Zeitgeist movement or 9/11 truth or people who are like way out in like conspiracy land, who will accuse me of being a shill And most of it will be typed out in regular case, but emphasized in capital letters, and it just comes off like a lunatic. And so I'm not going to get into the specifics of what the arguments that I was. You can go and watch the back and forth that him and I had. But one of the things that ended up happening was Matt Zielinski ended up contacting me through my Facebook page and had a discussion with me, and he was like, I don't know who this Shane guy is, but he seems to be off his fucking rocker. And I was like, that seems to be the case. That's been my experience as well. And he sent me a couple of screenshots that took place between him in Facebook Messenger or whatever. Now, some of those screenshots, they were like incomplete. Like, he was basically showing me like the highlight of the conversation. It turned out that he didn't show me like the complete conversation. There was a couple of exchanges that weren't included that may have changed the context of it just ever so slightly, like not enough to like to really warrant like any kind of claim to you know, quote mining or anything like that. I mean, like some of the context did provide some, you know, some extra, some of the comments did provide a little extra context, but not enough to really like warrant the realm of dishonesty or anything like that. It really was not that important. It really wasn't. And he provided this to me, and he immediately started accusing me and Matt Zielinski of like lying and in cahoots with each other. Which, by the way, like, this was the only interaction that I've ever had with Matt Zielinski. Ever. And it's been a few years. And he pointed out that no, like we were lying and blah, blah, blah. And like, you know, he was taking things out of context. And I was like, you're insane, Shane. Like, you're fucking insane. I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. Like, he gave me those texts, and I ended up providing screenshots, the very same screenshots that he showed me, that he gave me permission to share. Now, whether or not it was ethical because Shane didn't approve, didn't matter. You mean you're talking about two public figures who were having a private conversation of a public discourse. So I don't know what the ethics is of that, but I thought it was very kind of important to show. And apparently he did too. And he said, like, yes, go ahead, by all means, share. And, you know, and then it wasn't until later that Shane provided the context of the conversation, like some extra context, but again, didn't really matter. But he was showing that proves that I was lying. Not that Matt Zielinski was lying, because Matt Zielinski had only shared those particular screenshots with me, but that I was doctoring these pictures. Now, I didn't say this initially. What he said initially was that I was lying because I didn't show all the screenshots. And then it wasn't until I had a back and forth with Esoteric Entity, because Esoteric Entity was deleting my comments, and I had proof of it, and whatever, that's a whole different discussion. But Shane in the comments was like, well, he doctored screenshots of me. And I was like, I'm sorry, I doctored screenshots? No. Like, I don't know what you're talking about. And I ended up having to go on to another account because he had me blocked. And the reason why I even knew that he was commenting was because under this other account, like, I had to verify whether or not my comments were being deleted, because it's Esoteric Entity and that's what he does. And I saw that Shane had commented on it, and I was like, okay. And I commented on my alternative account, like, what do you mean? Like, which one were you saying? And he was talking about the Matt Zielinski ones. And I was like, I thought we made this kind of clear to begin with, like previously, that I was just providing the ones that were given to me. Yes, you did provide some extra content. I don't think it's relevant. You think it does, but it's clearly not. Like, what do you mean, like, I doctored the screenshots? Like, I don't know what you mean. And then he started going into this thing about how I'm a liar because I'm a liar because I should have known that Matt Zielinski was lying when he was talking about Roth. And I was like, wait, this doesn't have anything to fucking do with me doctoring screenshots. Like, I've already said to you that, yes, there was extra comments in the thing. I couldn't have possibly have known that. But you accused me of lying because I omitted parts of this conversation, but you now are saying that I doctored. I don't even know what the fuck you mean by that. And you're now admitting that that those things were not doctored, but just messages were not shown. And you know, there were some extra screenshots that could have been shown. And I could have known that. There's no way I could have known that because I was not privy to the conversation, which he tried to say that it was a public conversation. And then later on going like, oh yeah, but this was unethical because this is a private conversation. So, I mean, Shane is a liar. And it's very clear that he fucking lies when he's backed into a corner. Because right when this was like coming out, I was like, what the fuck are you even talking about, Shane? Like you're being insane again. It went into he was upset because he had to dig out some information to prove me wrong, which ended up proving him wrong. But he tried to dig up some information, but he couldn't find the comment that I left on his YouTube channel because I had blocked him. The problem was I never blocked Shane from my content or my YouTube channel or Google Plus ever. I've never have. And once it was revealed to him that, no, Shane, I did not block you. You have me blocked. That's why you can't see my comments. That narrative went to, it went from like I blocked him and I'm terrible for blocking him to, oh no, I blocked you because you blocked me a long time ago and I couldn't see comments by that, and it upset me that I could see these comments and I couldn't respond to them because I was blocked, so therefore I blocked you. But that's not actually what happened. What really happened was he ended up making a video later on about this logical fallacy that he made up whole cloth that's not logically fallacious. And he said that he was upset, and I'll pull up a screenshot of this, and I'll link it in the description, where he says, like, I am blocking you because you are constantly like disagreeing with me in the chat room, and you know you're borderline on crazy talk or whatever. It was something along those lines. I have to dig it up exactly what the conversation was. But it's very clear that he's giving his reasons for blocking me from his YouTube channel, and it had nothing to do with that. So Shane Killian is an intellectual fraud. He's a liar. He's completely fucking batshit nut crazy. And I want people who have had similar experiences, whether you're a YouTube creator yourself or you've never done this before, to create a video or something that affirms that this is true, because a lot of people don't believe it, because it really kind of gets hidden in the comment sections where you don't really get to see it that much. It happens on Twitter in the reply section, which doesn't really make it into a lot of people's Twitter feeds. It doesn't really show up too much on other media. What you really get is this kind of rosy painted picture of Shane Killian when you watch and subscribe to his YouTube channel. But what you don't see is the very absurd nature that is Shane Killian. Shane Killian is not the kind of person that you would expect to join like the skeptic community. And I don't mean the skeptic community that exists now, which basically is just like, oh, let's go after like crazy SJWs on YouTube. I mean, like back in the day when skepticism meant like you went after like pseudoscience and irrationality and all that sort of thing. Or libertarianism, because he really doesn't know too much about logic. He doesn't know too much about philosophy. He doesn't really know too much about that stuff. What he does say in his videos when it has to do with those things is he basically regurgitates people who are right. And I think that if Shane had never found the skeptic community, if he never found the atheist community, if he never found libertarian community, he would be a crazy nut job conspiracy theory shouting about reptoid people and flat earth, because nothing demonstrates that this guy is intellectually honest or that he understands logic or that he understands any of this stuff. And what he does understand, it's just basically regurgitated from people who are very much smarter than him. And he just seems to want to fit in that crowd. And so he regurgitates things that are in that crowd. I do find it interesting, and I always find it interesting because I'm always looking, every once and again, I'll go and look for people who are arguing with Shane Killian, And it seems to be like a common thread where you'll say people, you'll see people that say, you know, I respect Shane Killian. Like he's done a lot of great work. And then I have this interaction with him and I think he's insane. And you can go and watch like lots of videos on YouTube. Look up criticisms of Shane DK. You'll see this. It's a common thread of every single one of the criticisms that come out about Shane where, maybe not initial because, you know, maybe their first video, they think that he's a really rational guy and they're trying to have a dialogue with him. And then usually by the second video or maybe like having an interaction and then making a video based on that reaction that they finally figure out that this guy is completely off the fucking rails. He's completely off the fucking reservation in terms of rationality and reason and logic and, anything like that. I know that Eagle Eye 1975 had made a video and he basically expressed very similar concerns and that video is down. I wish that he just privated it and he still has it somewhere. If not, if he, Eagle Eye, that'd be a great way to come back to YouTube is to talk about Shane. I really want people to like talk about their experiences with it because it really needs to be said and people really need to be like made aware of this. And it's not because I'm trying to like get him off of YouTube or anything like that, because some of his videos, a lot of his videos, the plurality of his videos, the bulk of his videos are really good, but he makes a couple of bad videos here and there, which is fine because everybody makes bad content from time to time. I've made content where I wasn't particularly happy with the results or whatever. You know, and have taken them down. Or, you know, I've made bad arguments in the past and stuff like that. And I've been very hostile to people who are in my comment section. That's all fine. But I've ended up having to concede things to people and being like, you know what? You were wrong. I was right. I was a jerk. My bad. Like, I should have known. I've done this and it's very, you can see it. You can see me doing it. A lot of times in the comment section or on Twitter, or Facebook before I just started spamming it with Trout Mask Replica. But Shane doesn't do this. Shane, once he figures out that he's wrong, he just doubles down and lies. And he starts trying to gaslight people into thinking that, you know, they're wrong by making up shit and like moving the goalpost all the time. I really encourage, I'm gonna link to some comments and try to get some screenshots of some of this stuff. I don't know if I can be able to find some of it because a lot of it was kind of hidden because, you know, he's had me blocked. I can still see a lot of my comments on people who I know have me blocked on their channel. So I'll try to dig out a lot of them and post them in the comment section. Another good place to see a lot of this stuff is in his tweets and replies on his Twitter, because he does that on Twitter. Like he'll go and write these insanely like nutso fucking like responses to people on his tweets and replies. You have to click that little tab where you see him responding to people. Otherwise, you just see a very kind of very clean, very rational kind of rosy picture of Shane if you just look at his regular tweet stream. Yeah, this guy's completely fucking unhinged. And I think it's funny that Mr. Dapperton, who, by the way, I have lots of criticisms about him and his channel, but it's not nearly as same as I have for Shane Killian, that's for sure, made like this video where he was talking about Trudeau Tom, and Trudeau Tom was being like very harsh, very fucking harsh to Shane Killian. But he was giving like good reasons why he was being harsh. And I completely agree with him, and I'm very harsh to Shane too. And it mostly has to do with the way he presents himself to his detractors. But he just basically cut and pasted all the stuff that, you know, Trudeau Tom was saying about him and saying like, "Wow, this guy is a complete fuckface. He's a jerk rather." But he completely like glosses over the fact that Shane is 800 million times worse. Like, sure, Trudeau Tom called him a liar. He called him what do you call him, a degenerate and an unhinged degenerate and all this other stuff. But if you look at the things that he was responding to in that video, and he even provides the screenshots of, like, he's saying just as bad stuff back. I mean, he was calling him a dingleberry. I don't know if he even knows what a dingleberry is. It's basically a fucking turd that's dangling by one of your ass hairs from your ass. I mean, so, I mean, if you're mad that he's calling him a piece of shit, well, okay, then Shane was calling him a piece of shit, too. By the way, I really don't have a problem with people being a jerk during discourse. I really don't. I have a problem with it when it's being used to distract from the fact that you got caught saying something that is wrong or inaccurate or a deliberate falsehood. That's when I have a problem with it. You know, like, I'm a jerk. I really am. Like, I have no problem admitting that I'm a complete fucking asshole to my degenerate dissenters. But I make sure that I'm at least right before I'm being a jerk. If someone has some valid criticisms, I may be a jerk to them initially, and then I'll realize, like, oh shit, they're right. Like, I guess I was wrong. My bad. Or I at least try to take criticism when I get it to try to, like, okay, was I wrong here? Maybe I am wrong here. Because that's usually where I try to start with a lot of this stuff. Unless it's the Zeitgeist Movement, because they're 100% wrong all the time. But anyways, I mean, I've been going on for a while now. But yeah, I really want to hit this home. If you've had some interactions with Shane, I would really appreciate it if you would at least talk about your experiences, and I'll try to create like a playlist on my YouTube channel so that people can like have like a good resource of, you know, people who have had some very similar experiences, because a lot of people don't know. I mean, True Deal Tom was a fan of his for quite some time, and he just completely just did not know. And it was, yeah, it's something that's really kind of shocking to figure out once you've been a fan of his for so long, that you finally realize, like, this guy is not fucking rational. He's not what he portrays himself to be. He is basically a crazy conspiracy theory nut job who just happened to fall in with the right camp versus the wrong camp, and parrots a lot of their good stuff rather than, like a nut job's bullshit conspiracy theorist. That's what he is. Like, if he just happened to fall into the right crowd. So good on him for finding the right crowd. Bad on him for not really learning anything from it and just kind of just parroting off a lot of, you know, the, you know, stuff from really good people. It's a shame. It really is a shame, because the guy really can produce some quality work. He really can produce some really good stuff. But it's just under this really bad foundation. And, you know, I really don't want to see him or his channel gone. What I really want him to see is for him to, like, to really realize what he's doing and to make a change for the best. I'm not holding my breath, by the way. I'm really not. But, I just spent my entire duration of my lunch break sitting in my car talking about Shane Killian on my cell phone. By the way, just a quick side note for all those kind of YouTube content creators who have shitty audio. Your cell phone has great audio. Just record with that and then fucking put it into your video editor, for fuck's sake. Stop making shit audio. Stop it. You have no excuse. Anyways, I'll talk to you guys later. Hail Xenu. Hail Satan.